Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel, or if you're new here, welcome. Today is Friday, January 19th, and I just got home from work, and I wanted to show you a couple things I picked up. It was my payday yesterday, and my husband's payday today, so that means this weekend sometime is going to be doing time to do a grocery shop. I did pick up a couple things today at my workplace. If you're new to my channel, my name is Janice, and I live in Manitoba, Canada, and I'm a cashier at a Canadian grocery store chain called Sobeys. I do some of my shopping there. We get a 10% corporate discount each week. It's 10% on the first $150 spent every week. So basically the maximum you can save each week is $15 if you max out your weekly cap. And that goes from Monday to Sunday. I don't always use the entire thing because I just don't have the budget for that. But some weeks, depending on what's on sale, sometimes I do. I do some of my shopping there because of the discount, but also because they are a Scene Plus sponsor. If you're familiar with Scene Points at all, the original Scene card was just basically a movie card. You would earn points by going to Cineplex, by going to the movies, and you could redeem them for going to the movies. You could also earn points at that time at restaurants like Montana's, but the main thing that you could redeem points on was to go to the movies. Well, a couple of years ago, fall of 2022, Sobeys and Safeway stopped being an Air Miles sponsor and switched to Scene Plus. And so they basically Scene kind of upgraded itself to Scene Plus, and so now you can earn groceries, or you can earn points by going to the movies, but also, as usual, by eating at Montana's and different places, but also by shopping at Safeway, Sobeys, and IGA. And you can redeem them in-store, just like you could for Air Miles Cash. You could redeem Air Miles Cash in-store in Safeway and Sobeys towards groceries. You can also redeem your Scene Plus points there, in addition to using them at the movie theater. So we, long story short, Safeway and Sobeys are now, as of a year and a half ago, Scene Plus sponsors. So a big part of a lot of my grocery shopping I do at Real Canadian Superstore for their PC Optimum Points program, but I do some of my shopping at Sobeys because as an employee there, I do get a discount each week and because of the points. And these were pretty much all points offers. So one thing, if you've watched my videos at all, right now the birds are quiet, but usually they're in fine form and singing at the top of their lungs. But I'm a bird owner, so we have parrots here. And usually they're squawking away. And sometimes when I do grocery hauls, I show you what I picked up at Petland for them too. I haven't done that yet this paycheck. But they need more than just their store-bought bird food. They need people food too. So sometimes I make them what's called chop, where I'll make them some brown rice and maybe cook up some frozen vegetables and put it in. Or occasionally put some cut up fruit and give them that as well. Quite often if my African grey parrot Ruby is out of the cage when I'm eating supper, quite often she'll be all over me, especially if there's mashed potatoes on my plate. She loves that. So I decided to buy, I saw that we had these Compliments brand. Compliments is the Sobeys store brand. They saw that we had some of these on sale. Actually, when I look back now at the PC, at the Superstore shopping app, because you can download that app and you can shop online, because both Superstore and Sobeys have curbside pickup. And when you look at the Superstore shopping app, I think these frozen vegetables might have been a little bit cheaper there per bag. These were, how much were they? I want to say at Sobeys they were $3.99 a bag. Yeah, they're $3.99 a bag before my discount. I think at Superstore they might have been more like $2.99 a bag. So technically they may have been a little bit cheaper at Superstore per bag. However, I do have my 10%, so $3.99 each of these three bags of vegetables, and then minus my 10% on each of them. And if you buy for each one bag of these vegetables that you bought, I earned 100 Scene points. So they were $3.99 each. I bought two diced butternut squash. I thought that would be a good thing to put in their chop. And a bag of harvest vegetables. It looks like broccoli, carrots, cauliflower, maybe green beans. Is it green beans? Let me see. I can't tell if that's green. It might be green beans or snap peas. I think it's green beans. So, and my daughter she's the only one in the house that likes broccoli and cauliflower, so that will appeal to her too. But I can put some of this in the bird's chop, and I can cook some up for her as well. She's really the only one in the house that likes broccoli and cauliflower other than the birds. Me, I'm a peas and corn kind of girl as far as hot cooked vegetables. So even though at Superstore they may have been $2.99 each and they were $3.99 at Sobeys, that's $3.99 less 10% on each of those bags and $100 per bag. Every 1,000 points is $10, so that's $1 worth of points on each bag as well. So I bought three of those. I have also seen on the Superstore app that you can buy a bag of frozen sweet potato chunks. I did not see that at my store, so I did not get that. I'll have to get that at Superstore. But I picked those up, and then in the reduced bin, we have some candy. Maynard's candy. These are tropical Swedish berries. You can see they were regular $3.99. 50% off. They are discontinued. Well, maybe not discontinued. They're probably just getting close to their best before date is probably what the issue was. So half off of that. So basically $2 off each one, and then 10% off over and above that. And what I didn't realize was if I bought two, I would earn 50 points. So let me show you what the breakdown was here. You can see the Maynards, I had $2 off each bag, 50 points because I bought two. And then each of the bags of frozen veg were $3.99 and 100 points per bag. And then on this order, I had my corporate employee discount was $1.61. So after tax, I only paid $14.94 for these few items. And you can see there, I earned 350 points. So going into this, I had 3,268 Scene Plus points, which you can only redeem in increments of $10, just like the PC Optimum program. So that means going into this, I was at the $30 points mark, and I earned 350. So after this, when this hits my account, I will be sitting at 3,618, I believe, if my math is correct. That will still have me at the $30 in points mark. But considering I started out in January with zero, because at Christmas time, I used up all of my Scene Plus points I saved in 2023, I'm starting from scratch. I don't think I'm doing too bad. So the fact that in less than a month, I've managed to earn back over $30 in points is pretty good, I think. So let me get this stuff put away in the freezer and I will pause you. And then once I go and do my Superstore shopping, I will come back and insert that clip next. All right, today is now Monday, January 22nd, and I want to show you a couple items that I picked up on Saturday at Walmart. I did just come from doing a Real Canadian Superstore grocery pickup, and I'm going to insert that after this clip. But I just want to film this first, and then I'll film that for you. These are items I picked up at Walmart on Saturday. In addition to working as a cashier at a grocery store, I also have a second job, part-time job at a elementary school as a lunch supervisor, and I'm working with a grade 2 class. And Valentine's Day is coming up, and so I like to put together little goodie bags for each of the holidays, whether Halloween, Christmas, Valentine's, Easter, what have you. And I know sometimes the school is pretty particular about not sending candy, not sending food items, just because of allergies and whatnot. So instead I was trying to find other things that my students might be able to give to my students instead. So I found some Play-Doh. I believe I have 21 or 22 kids in my class, I'm not sure. But these are two 12 packs of colored Play-Doh from Walmart, and they were $6.98 a package. And two little mini packs of bubble wands, 12 in each package, with little hearts on the top. I thought these were really cute, $1.98. I already have little cellophane treat bags I bought at Dollarama in the past. I have different ones from Valentine's, Halloween, Christmas theme. Pretty sure I have enough Valentine ones left over. If not, I'll go to Dollarama this week and pick some up, because I'm going for a haircut later this week and Dollarama's in the same strip mall as my hair salon. And then these glow bracelets, I bought three packages of these, $1.98 each. Yes, I said I bought three packages, even though it says 24. No, I did not buy 72 glow bracelets. There's 24 pieces in each pack, in each package. There's eight glow sticks, eight cards, and eight connectors. So each of these, even though it's 24 pieces, each of these will basically make, each of these packages will each make eight glow bracelets. So three packages of eight, that's 24, because I've got 24 Play-Doh, 24 bubble ones, and 24 glow bracelets to make here. So that'll be fine. And the gift bags that I have are usually 12 in a package, so that'll be fine. I think I have 21 or 22 kids, so I might have a couple left over, but that's totally all right. I'd rather have too many than not enough. And then the only other thing I bought at Walmart, the glow bracelets were also $1.98 a package as well, same as the bubble ones. And then the only other thing I bought at Walmart was $3.47 each, some packages of luncheon meat, $3.47, that's correct. So Cajun chicken breast and oven roasted turkey breast. I've had these in the freezer the last couple days. And the oven roasted chicken breast back here. That's why this one looks like this package is not full, because it's not. I bought this on Saturday and it's now Monday, and I've been taking some of it out of there already to make sandwiches for work. So that one has already almost used up, as you can see. And then these two have been sitting in the freezer. I'm going to put these back in now. So what I spent at Walmart on Saturday was a total of 37:13 after tax. So now I will film the Superstore haul and I'll upload that next. So stay tuned. I'll be back in just a moment with that. Alrighty, and now on to what I picked up at Superstore today. Actually, what I decided to do today was I spent an extra $1 and placed a order for Superstore grocery pickup. My daughter and I both work together at Sobeys, but we also both work together at the school lunch program. And so today last night I placed an order for Superstore grocery pickup and decided to say, okay, you know what? After the school, we'll finish about 12:45, 12:50. We'll pick up our groceries around 1 o'clock. So I stopped at Superstore at the gas bar and got $30 worth of gas and got some points there and then pulled into our stall and got our grocery pickup order. Actually, I'm just going to grab my other receipt over here. I ended up paying $30 for gas at the gas bar. I can't speak, sorry guys. 910 points there. That left me with a balance of 10,384 points before picking up my groceries. So that means that finally I'm back at the $10 mark of PC Optimum points. So I'm going to go over everything I picked up. Some of these things were just things we needed. Some of them had points on them. But at the end of this all, I'm going to do something different and break down for you what I have actually spent this month in total in groceries. I haven't really tracked before just exactly how much I spend in any given month. And so I've done two grocery hauls already earlier this month. If you saw, there's one that was called First Grocery Haul of 2024. And then there's another one that was called Meat Stock Up, where I got a bunch of meat that was on sale at Sobeys. And I've gone through and deducted from there, from those totals, any items that were not grocery related. Because usually I do a grocery haul and I say, oh, this is my total. And it includes pharmacy things and household things too, which is fine. But I'm curious just exactly what I am spending on groceries. And maybe some of you are as well. So I'll break that down for you in just a few minutes. And let me just show you what I got. I'm going to try and find the prices on here. You guys know I'm still struggling to do that, to find the prices off to one side here. So if you hear crinkling of my receipt, please forgive me. I'm just sort of trying to figure it out as I go here. I'm still trying to get good at this. Okay, so we're out of caffeine in this house, short of other than coffee, that is. But I tend to prefer cold caffeine like Diet Coke or Diet Pepsi. And so we're out. So I ordered a 12-pack each of Diet Pepsi and of Cherry Pepsi, so Cherry regular Pepsi and just regular Diet Pepsi. They were $5.99 each for the 12-packs. Not the greatest price. I have seen them on sale cheaper at different places, both at my store and Superstore. But hey, I'm out of my caffeine. I needed some. So there was actually 1,000 points. There was like 500 points on each. It looks like on each of the packages of Pops. So 500 points each there, so that's 1,000 points. And then I decided, because I struggle so much with my insomnia, to get some melatonin. I have taken melatonin in the past, and I always feel kind of like really sluggish the next day. But I started physiotherapy last week, and when I talked to my physiotherapist, he says, you know what, it's probably because you're taking 10 milligrams, and you're not that big of a person. You should probably cut it in half or get the 5-milligram pills instead. He says that would be a better dose for you. So I decided to try that out. I got a bottle of those. I believe these were $5.59. Life Brand is, Superstore is part of the Loblaws company. And in Eastern Canada, I guess in like the Maritime provinces, you can have like Atlantic Superstore out there. But when I lived in Ontario years ago, we didn't have Superstore, but we had Loblaws. And it's the same family of stores. And actually, Optimum Points are, you can earn and redeem Optimum Points at No Frills, which is part of Loblaws, or at Superstore, or just at Loblaws, depending on if that's what you have, but also at Shoppers Drug Mart. And President's Choice and No Name Brand are the store brands for Superstore, but Life Brand is the Shoppers store brand. And for whatever reason, we do have some Life Brand products in Superstore, even though it's a Shoppers Drug Mart thing. But I guess because it's the same family of stores, that's probably why. So that's a Life Brand melatonin. And then these Life Brand enzyme digestive tablets are something my husband wanted me to pick up. Those were $7.19. And then I did order a deodorant for myself. I believe that is $3.99. Cheetos, it's not a healthy thing, but it's a snack. And, you know, shopping hungry is, you know, it's just as bad shopping online hungry as shopping in person and shopping hungry. Really, it's really neither one is good. Bad, mistakes happen sometimes, you know, poor choices, I guess. But whatever, I mean, it's one bag. It's, you know, they were six, no, they're not, sorry. Oh, almost dropped my drop my receipt, so then I jerked my tablet too. Sorry about that, guys. They were $3.99 for a bag, which actually isn't a bad price for them right now. Sometimes they're like $4 something or even $5 something. So that's $3.99 for a bag of Cheetos. I'm justifying my impulse buy that way. Mushrooms, these will be for a sheet pan meal I'd like to do later in the week. I have farmer sausage in the deep freeze, and I like to do a sheet pan meal sometimes with farmer sausage, cut up tomatoes. I guess you could do tomatoes if you wanted to, but usually I do cut up farmer sausages and mushrooms and potatoes. You could put any kind of vegetable you want in with there too, like, you know, peppers, what have you, and then just drizzle a little bit of oil on there and toss them in a bit of like a spice mix or what have you and bake it in the oven. It's really quite nice. So the mushrooms are primarily for that. Finished dishwasher detergent was on sale. I almost want to say that the mushrooms, I think I might have had a points offer on. I can't recall. I'll check my receipt in a minute. Finished dishwasher tablets, they were on sale, and they are on my points offers. $18.99. They're regular $24.99. Rice, brown rice. It's instant rice, but it's brown rice that's a little bit healthier than white rice, I suppose. And this is what I like to make when we have rice and for whatever we're serving it with. But I also like to make a bit of this when I make the chop for the birds and put some of that in there because it's better for them than the white rice, just like it would be better for us, too. And some Italian-style seasoning. This I picked up because I saw a video recipe for hamburger soup, and it called for a little bit of Italian style seasoning. I have lots of spices in the house, but I don't think I have that. It's $2.49. And the rice, I want to say, I'm trying to find where the price was on that. I think it was seven. I want to say the rice was seven something. I'm seeing if I can find it here. Oh, it's right underneath the Italian seasoning on my receipt. I couldn't even see it. The rice was $6.49. And then I don't have to look for the price on this, it's right here. Popcorn chicken, $10, 1.13 kilograms, 4 liters of 1% milk, and that is $5.58. Armstrong cheese, just one block of marble. I thought that I had ordered a medium cheese too. I could be wrong. It has this, Armstrong cheese has been on my offers in the past. It is not this week. I may have to just go back in and get another block of cheese or something. I just like to have cheese on hand. I like to eat cheese, but I also am making a taco dip later this week, so I do need to have a little more cheese in the house than just this one block. This coming Saturday is a birthday party, a family gathering for my mother-in-law's 80th birthday, and I can't go. I have to work, so I'm sending some other, my husband will go on my on our behalf. And I told them, though, that I would bring or send some munchies. So I'm planning on making a taco dip to send along. So I need some cheese to grate. But this cheese is primarily to put in sandwiches or to eat, for me, at least in my opinion, anyway. So I would like to get another block of cheese. I'll have to pop into Superstore on my way home from the school one day this week and grab some medium cheese or something, or old cheddar or something, just for grating. But that was on sale for $7.97. Actually, it was a limit of one. Otherwise, it would have been $10.79. So it's just as well that I got one for now. So I can go back in later this week and get another one before the sale ends. But just buying them one. I could have probably done it in a separate transaction, but not if you're not shopping in person. If it's on the PC Optimum app, you know, you're paying for it all in one fell swoop, right? So I'll just stop in. I'm working at the school on Wednesday. I'll pop in then and grab a block of marble or a block of medium or something and get the sale price before it ends. Cream cheese, this is also for the taco dip, and again, the Black Bar, it says no name, that is the store brand, and that was $3. It's a little bit cheaper than Philadelphia brand. Two cans of Italian style canned tomatoes. They are, they were $2.69 each. Four boxes of Nutri-Grain bars. I like to have these on hand to munch on in the morning or to even just toss in my work lunch. When I work at Sobeys, I'm working anywhere from 5 hours, usually around 5-6 hours. Sometimes it can be a longer shift, but quite often it's anywhere from 4 to 6 hours. Usually 5 or 5.5 is kind of the usual. So I got a box each of strawberry, apple cinnamon, blueberry, and raspberry Nutri-Grain bars just so I can have something to eat on my break at work. And I'm trying to find the price if I can. Right here they are. $2.97, limit of 6. And then some frozen vegetables. Some of these will go in chop for the birds. Some will just be for us to have with our meals. Peas and carrots and corn. And let's see, they were $5.99 each, limit of 4. And then some celery stalks over here. Those were actually $1.97. That's as good of a price as I've seen on celery stocks anywhere for quite some time. And then the sweet potato, remember I was, when in the earlier part of this video, I talked about what I picked up at Sobeys and how I got the frozen squash there, but I could not find the sweet potato. And I also looked in Walmart. I couldn't find it there. So I just put them on the grocery order here because they are in the flyer. They're on sale for $2.99 each. I think there was a limit of four, but I just got two of the same right now. I thought I'll start with this and see, make sure the birds actually like it. But at least I know that if I can't, if it's not something at Walmart or Sobeys carries, at least I know Superstore does carry it. And a 2 pound bag of baby carrots. Where is that? That is a $3.99 bag. And then some tomatoes. This is going to be some of these, probably two or three of these will be cut up and go onto the taco dip. Some of this might just go in a salad. I'm thinking I bought a head of lettuce as well, thinking that perhaps maybe I could make taco salad at some point this week, in which case I'll use some of the tomatoes in that and some on the taco dip. The iceberg lettuce was $1.99, which is actually pretty good. It usually is a lot more than that. And these tomatoes were $3.89. So the points, let me show you what I got here for points. What did I get today? How did I make out? Will this focus? Carbonated soft drinks, that's the 1,000 points. Packaged mushrooms, 400 points. 3,200 points for the finished dishwasher. So after taxes, I spent 148.04. So you can see the 1,000 points down there. Actually, there's an in-store offer of 1,000 points as well. I'm not sure what that was for, but that's okay. I'll take it. So, because up here, these points here total 4,600 points. So my digital offers, which are the offers on my app, for the pop, the mushrooms, and the dishwasher, that's 4,600 points. And apparently there's a 1,000 point in-store offer. So I earned a bonus 1,000 points there. So that leaves me now with a closing balance of 15,984 points. That is, puts me at the $15 mark of PC Optimum points. But you can only redeem in increments of $10. But still, I started out at zero at the start of this month. And now I'm back up to $15. So now, of this 148.04, how much of this was actually groceries? I had, the two pharmacy items here. There was a $7.19 and a $5.59. These two right here. And the deodorant was $3.99. And the dishwasher detergent was $18.99. So of the $148.04, what I actually spent on groceries today was $112.28. So today I spent $112.28 on groceries. From my Walmart pickup my Walmart purchase the other day, all that was groceries there were three packs of sandwich meat, 347 times three. So I spent $10.41 of groceries at Walmart and $112.28 of groceries today at Superstore. And of my Sobeys items the other day, well, my Sobeys items were $14.94. So this week, from this video, what I spent in total on groceries was $137.63 for this video. So I'm just going to turn you around and I'm going to go over with you what I've spent so far this month on groceries. Okay, now I'm going to go over some numbers with you all. I've never really done this before. I've never really ventured into budgeting type videos. Or given you a breakdown of like what a total spend for a month is for us or anything like that. So this is kind of a first for me to be doing this, but I'm going to talk to you about what I've spent for the month so far. We're a family of three, although my daughter is an adult child, but still she lives at home and she does buy some of her own snack food items, but we still provide the bulk of the main food items, the grocery budget. A lot of times when I do my grocery hauls, I say, okay, this is my total. And you'll see in there that some things are pet items, some things are pharmacy items, and I don't always take the time to break down what's what. And so that's kind of what I was trying to do in this video, is kind of go back and say, hey, in this haul today, what I picked up at Superstore, this is what was grocery and this is what was not. So I've done a couple of other hauls so far this month, only two other big videos. So I'm going to just go over with you what each of those cost and what was included and what I actually spent for the month. It's January 22nd right now. There's 9 days left in January, but it's Monday, the 22nd right now. I don't get paid again now until a week from Thursday. So this is probably all I will be spending until either a week from Thursday or a week from Friday. And that, let's see, would that be... Next Monday would be the 29th, Wednesday would be the 31st. So technically, yeah, I guess Thursday payday would be February 1st, and then Friday my husband's payday would be February 2nd. So I guess technically that would be starting on February grocery spending, because I won't be probably shopping any major shop again until a week from Thursday, which is February 1st, and then his payday is February 2nd. So probably somewhere between February 1st and 3rd, I'll do a grocery shop. So this is basically going to cover all of what I spent in January, unless I need to go pick up the odd one or two little things here and there. But anyway, so back on January 4th, I went to Superstore and I purchased $201.57. Well, the total was $161.57, but I also did $40 cash back that day. That was a previous video. That was the one titled First Grocery Haul of 2024. In that, so of the $201.57 total, $40 was cash back. Also included was $13.97 for a bag of budgie seed, $13.97 for a bag of cockatiel seed, $25.49 for Imodium, which would be pharmacy/toiletries, and $9.99 times two for tampons, also under pharmacy/toiletries, and $5.99 for a box of kitchen garbage bags, so household. So $201.57 minus $40 cash back, $13.97 times two for pet, $25.49 and $9.89 times two for toiletries, and $5.99 for household. That meant I spent on that grocery haul $119.44 on non-grocery items, and a total of $82.13 for groceries. On my Sobeys meat stock up, that bill was entirely groceries. That was $168.64. I can't recall. I don't think there was any non-grocery items in there. It was all meat and canned flakes of ham, flakes of turkey, flakes of chicken that were on sale for points offers, Dempster's bagels. It was pretty much, I believe, all grocery items. And a lot of it was because it was a meat stock up. There was a really good meat sale and there was points offers on a lot of items. So that was $168.64. And then in this video, part one was Sobeys, all grocery items, $14.94. Second part of today's video was Walmart, $37.13. However, of that $37.13, only $26.72 were Valentine's type supplies for my students, for my classroom at school. So that meant that of the $37.13 at Walmart, only $10.41 was spent on groceries. And then in the last part of this video is my total was $148.04. Of that total, $7.19 were the digestive tablets for my husband. $5.59 were the melatonin for me. So those would be under toiletries or pharmacy. And the $3.99 deodorant for myself. And then $18.99 dishwasher tablets under household. That is $35.76 from part three of today's video that were non-grocery items, leaving me with a total of $112.28 that were grocery items from today. So of today's video, part one, Sobeys $14.94, all grocery. Part two, Walmart $10.41 was grocery. And $112.28 of part three were grocery today. The rest of it was toiletries and household items. And there was one other thing that I forgot to mention, and that was a Sobeys purchase last night after work. I did not film that. All I bought was a container of hummus and some hot dog buns, $9.88. So, what have I spent for the whole month? I spent the first grocery haul, $82.13. Though these are grocery items. These are after I've subtracted all the, this is what I just went over with you. And then my meat haul, $168.64. And then part one of this video, $14.94 Sobeys. $10.41 part two of this video, Walmart. $112.88 part three of this video, Superstore. And the $9.88 from Sobeys last night that I didn't film because it was just two items. So $82.13, $168.64, $14.94, $10.41, $112.88, and $9.88. This is all the grocery items I bought in January so far. I've spent a total of $398.88 on groceries for the month of January for a family of three. I don't think that's too bad. And in the process of it, I've also earned back, as of today, $15 in PC Optimum points and over $30 in Scene Plus points back. Remember, I typically earn and accumulate Scene Plus points and PC Plus points all year long and try not to use them until Christmas time, and then I redeem them. On that way, with all the other expenses of the Christmas season, I have everything covered except for I have all my food covered. I just have to worry about postage for packages and buying gifts and whatnot and all those things. So I feel like I've done pretty well. To have spent just under $400 for groceries for an entire month, other than maybe there might be a couple things in the next 10 days I might need to be another bunch of bananas or a loaf of bread or whatever, but no major shops for the next 9 days because my next payday is about that far away. To have spent just shy of $400 for a family of three for an entire month on groceries, I feel is pretty good. Now, part of that is because I shop the points. I shop items at Superstore I know I'll earn points on that I can redeem later. And same thing with the Scene Plus points at Sobeys. And I take advantage of my corporate discount at Sobeys. But still, I feel like I've done pretty well. I've managed to spend only $400 for a family of three for a month and earn $15 in Scene Plus points back and over $15 of PC points back, and over $30 in Scene Plus points. Watching sales, shopping the points, taking advantage of my discount, being as careful as I can be. I have to be. I work two jobs for a reason, right? I mean, times are tough for everybody. Inflation has hit everybody hard. And that's just what it is. And I mean, during the winter months, especially, produce prices are higher than normal. Inflation has hit everybody. And yes, one final thing you can see in the background here, my Christmas tree is still up. It's January 22nd. It is still up. I never did do a video showing you all my Christmas decorations. It's probably too late now, but I mean, technically I could because they are still up. But this coming weekend, they will come down. Anyway, so that's my little foray into budgeting videos. I know this has made this video a little bit extra long, and I apologize for that. But a lot of people seem to really enjoy budgeting videos on YouTube, I've noticed. I know I enjoy watching some things like that. And I thought I would give you some kind of an idea of what our prices are here and how much I'm spending for our family and how I'm trying to be frugal as best I can. So I hope you guys have enjoyed this. I know it's a little extra long. I apologize for that. I apologize for being chatty. I hope you guys have enjoyed this anyway. I have to be extra frugal right now. We've had our Indian ringneck parrot at the vets 12 times now since early December. Long story, but he's had an injury that is just not, I mean, he'll pull through. He's healthy as a horse. It's just his injured toe that's the problem. That's costing us a lot of money. It's a half hour drive each way to this avian vet to get him there. My husband is now having to have dental work done. His work has pretty good benefits, but he is going to be out of pocket some. My car has had almost $1,000 of work done on it a couple weeks ago, and it needs to go in the shop again next week for a pretty major repair. The timing belt is gone, and the water pump needs repairing as well. So I have to be frugal. So if it sounds like, oh, good job, Janice, you're doing great. You know, you only spent $400 to feed your family. Well, yeah, but I also have to be careful because right now it's post-Christmas. So everybody's expenses, you know, they got to pay off their Christmas credit card bills, right? Which I actually don't have. I don't have a credit card. But with car repairs, dental bills, vet bills, I have to be careful. And especially because my jobs are both part-time, and with one being at a grocery store, it's essentially like working in retail. So typically you see your hours slump a little bit in the new year. So that means if your hours go down, so does your pay. So I'm trying to be careful, stock up when I see sales, shop the points, and I hope you guys have enjoyed this. And maybe other than that side of it, if you liked me talking about the financial side of things and the budgeting of it all, let me know and I'll continue doing that. So I hope you guys are having a great start to your week and a good winter. Hopefully winter's being decent to you and not too cold wherever you live. I hope you guys have enjoyed this. If you haven't already subscribed, please consider doing so. Hit the notification bell so you'll know when I post something. And I promise the next one will be a little shorter. And make sure you like the video if you did enjoy it and leave a comment down below so I can get to know you a little bit better. Have a great week, everybody, and we'll see you in the next video. Have a good week. See you next time.